Hi, welcome to this lesson on Autonomous Database Level 200 course. My name is Bal Sharma. I'm part of Oracle Cloud Infrastructure Product Management team. Let me take a pause here so that you can go through our safe harbor statement. So objectives for this lesson is going to be around these topics. So first one is we will focus on autonomous database in OCI as well as several deployment considerations. We will also look at database cloud service comparison because we have several database services under data management portfolio, and we'll see how they differentiate and their use cases. We will also talk about architecture and best practices for autonomous database dedicated. We'll try to understand the client connections for autonomous transaction processing database dedicated. We'll also talk about the security options which is available in autonomous transaction processing database. We'll discuss about high availability concepts which is applicable to this autonomous transaction processing. We'll talk about how we can roll out software updates and patching in autonomous database, as well as various developer tool and productivity which is available on autonomous database. We will talk ways to migrate to autonomous database, as well as various management and monitoring options which are available for autonomous databases. So let's start with the part one, where we will cover autonomous databases in OCI as well as various deployment considerations. So when it comes to autonomous database in OCI, we have basically two offerings. One is serverless as well as dedicated. And this is a family of product where each member of the family is optimized by the workload. We have data warehouse, which is optimized for analytic workload, like data warehouse, data marts, or even a data lake. ATP, on the other hand, is optimized for everything else. So it could be transaction processing or mixed workload environment, and that makes a great platform for any new application deployment. By autonomous, we mean everything is automatic in terms of provisioning, scaling up and scaling out, the tuning within these databases. When it comes to security and patching, we have a lot of automation there, as well as fault tolerance, because these are the characteristics of autonomous database. We use machine learning plus most proven technologies such as Exadata, Real Application Cluster, DataGuard, Database Vault, all sort of parallel SQLs or in-memory multi-tenant. So these are the enabler for autonomous databases. With the introduction of 19c, which is available on autonomous, we have machine learning, which optimizes the workload. We have several unique features like automatically creating indexes for transaction processing, or when it comes to data warehouse, we are automatically able to create the data summaries for analytics. We take advantage of columnar vector processing formats, and it is based on Exadata cloud infrastructure. So both of these offerings, serverless as well as dedicated, we use Exadata behind the scene. So Oracle database is instantly provisioned regardless of any database size in case of serverless, and there are no upfront infrastructure required. Or in case of dedicated, customer get a complete hardware stack which is completely isolated from any other tenants. And we have concepts such as virtual cloud networks that is enforced, and it provides you more control over application as well as database consolidation and patching when we talk about dedicated. In this slide, we are going to discuss how it compares both of these offerings, serverless versus dedicated. What are the primary goals or benefits you get across these offerings? Primary benefit when it comes to serverless, Oracle is managing or automating everything for you. In a sense, all the deployments or lifecycle or software updates, they are taken care by Oracle. Customer is just able to choose what kind of compute, how many OCPUs they want to enable, how much storage they need, as well as the region, etc. In terms of elasticity, you can start with lower minimum, so one OCPU can get you started on autonomous serverless, and a minimum time commitment is basically just an hour, and you can automatically scale online for a kind of true pay-per-use basis. On the other hand, autonomous database dedicated, mostly the primary benefits are around: it is your own database cloud which is running on dedicated Exadata infrastructure. It can run all of your database, any size, scale, or criticality. It provides you higher isolation. It runs inside a secure isolation zone so that it can provide you highest protection from any other tenants. So you can configure multiple Exadatas or container databases for intra-company kind of isolation. It provides you various customizable operational policies. So in terms of control of provisioning or updates, they are controlled by customer. In terms of availability and consolidation density, so they all comes with a dedicated offering. So now looking at serverless Exadata cloud infrastructure, serverless experience is the easiest thing for a customer to get. Oracle is managing everything. We leverage real application clusters for both serverless as well as dedicated. Customer just consumes the service. They can activate with one core, one OCPU, and they can scale out. So lower minimum commitment, as I said, just 1 hour, and it is designed for common compliance applications or public cloud applications. As you see, like, it is all based on Exadata infrastructure. On the other hand, autonomous transaction processing are dedicated, so some of the physical characteristic and constraint, it is designed for more mission critical databases, and where you need more control in terms of consolidation, ability to allocate dedicated environments. It again runs on Exadata hardware, that is the world's fastest database platform. It has fastest storage using latest NVMe flash. You have fastest communication using RDMA over InfiniBand. So a smart offload capability of queries of columnar cache in Exadata storage, and you can transparently do a scaling for both your OLTP as well as analytic applications. So the hardware which is available, Exadata Quarter Rack, it comes with two compute servers that can go all the way up to 92 OCPUs and roughly 1.5 terabyte of RAM. And from the three storage cells or storage servers which are present on in this Exadata infrastructure, you get roughly 77 terabyte of flash and 107 terabyte of usable disk capacity through a spinning disk. You have cluster of virtual cloud networks, so you can have one cluster per quarter rack at moment. You can have maximum of four per cluster in a container database, and in terms of high availability, service level agreements is on maximum 200 databases, or it provides extreme availability SLA of maximum 25 databases. Placement logic is based on, like, if you have less than 16 OCPU, it is open on one server. You can always do over provisioning, especially if you are planning for application testing and then rolling out to production. So those kind of scenario, you can it can support over provisioning. So maximum of 10 autonomous databases per OCPU is just a guideline. So in terms of selection considerations for serverless, that is definitely the easiest way to get you started with one core or 1 hour minimum. You can quickly test out all the ideas, or you can terminate when you are done with your work. So you don't have to worry about any placement or availability domain placement controls. So they are not there with serverless. And for PaaS scheduling or software versioning, since Oracle takes care of these kind of operations, so customers don't have to worry about these. You can use or basically configure Oracle application continuity or to minimize any downtime impact to maintenance. Cloning capabilities are available today in serverless, so that is for easier test database creation. Auto scaling is also available for hands-free scaling of variable workload, and functionally it is ready for any need to upgrade from serverless to dedicated for production kind of deployment. So it is always a good idea to test it out in a serverless and then decide on moving to a dedicated infra. So when it compares with dedicated, it is definitely a higher cost entry, and users must subscribe to a minimum of 1 month of Exadata infrastructure. Once subscribed, like you can test out the ideas and quickly and terminate when you complete. So no ongoing software cost. It includes availability domain placement control for latency sensitive applications. So response latency is in microseconds, and it is consistent over time. So there are no placement changes. Policy control for path scheduling and software versioning, which is different than serverless. So Oracle completely deals with all patching, but you can control what version and when you want to apply those changes. So it allows you to stage a specific version to your dev test or pre-production before production. Transparent application continuity automatically minimize any downtime impact to the maintenance. Test database creation requires an export to an import from the object storage, because that is the way you are able to bring any database to autonomous as of today. So cloning and auto scaling capabilities are also available. So some of the feature consideration, since most of the customers are coming from a kind of environment where they have complete control on things such as creating table space or user creations or indexes and things. So here you need to understand like what is different between this dedicated and serverless, because that helps you take a decision when it comes to solutioning. So in terms of create table space on dedicated, you can do that, but in serverless you have no flexibility. You cannot create a table space. Similarly, transparent application continuity is available, and in serverless only application continuity is available. Cloning support is going to be available in autonomous transaction processing dedicated. Right now it is not yet there, but in serverless it's available. Vault is available in dedicated, because database vault provides security controls so that operations can just do whatever they are supposed to in terms of patching without looking into the user data. So segregation of duties and all is very important, and database vault provide that. In terms of profiles, you have access to it uses database version 19c in case of dedicated, but in serverless you have only preview. But 19c will be also available maybe later in serverless. Auto scaling is not there at present. Auto indexing is part of dedicated, and in terms of RTO and RPO, it's documented and available with dedicated. OCI notification service are integrated here. Maintenance history and reporting is available in dedicated. And for complete list, the below link provides you details on what is unique to serverless as well as dedicated. You can go through them. Some of the other service feature comparison is VCN or private IP or Azure Secure Connect. So they all are available with dedicated. Backup retention configurations are available on dedicated. You can control the software update as well as versions, which is unique to dedicated. And SQL Dev Web or Enterprise Monitoring is available across both basically. So these tools can be used with both of the offerings. So in terms of non-TLS SQL StarNet, that is available on dedicated, but in serverless, it is always going to be encrypted TLS SQL StarNet connection. Rack session or co-location tagging, as well as skipping updates during critical business periods. So these all can be controlled on dedicated environment. So now moving to DB Cloud Service comparison, and we'll talk about various deployment considerations between autonomous versus automated. Automated is where we have provided a lot of things in automated fashion through scripts or toolings, but you have no machine learning or AI. So we'll talk about them in much detail. Primary use case for autonomous database, serverless is basically for data-driven results, or fast data-driven results, or log-wise data, or departmental store data for SMB customers or developers who wants to quickly deploy a database for their application development, or even for data scientists. So they could be some of the main use case for autonomous database, because this is the way we are basically differentiating. Developers were always depending on system admins or IT admins to get an environment, and it used to delay the entire process. But now they don't have to have knowledge on how this autonomous databases works. With a few clicks, they are able to get a functional database running in time. Then they would be able to do whatever is needed. So all database operations fully automated, user run SQL, they don't have access to operating system or container. It provides you Exadata kind of performance and availability, and customizable for data warehouse or transaction processing workload. So that is also a very unique feature. The same database Oracle provides can be customized or tuned for like different kind of workload behavior. So it is the same skill set. Which is going to probably manage both of these environments. So serverless, as I said, it's ultra simple and elastic, and dedicated provides you customizable private cloud in public cloud. So on the other hand, if we talk about autonomous database service, here we have automated the database lifecycle. User operates, they have DB access, they have operating system or root access to these systems. You would be able to run older database versions on automated DB services like 11z or 12z or 18 or 19. So all of the database features, including Java, is available on automated DB services. And two major offerings are, one is based on Exadata system, so Exadata Cloud Service or even Exadata Cloud at Customer. They provide scalability, the required performance for your mission critical workload, as well as availability requirements. The other offerings is around Database Cloud Service, which is provided on virtual machines for a smaller kind of workload, or bare metal instances, which are able to provide you single server, and database virtual machines provide you real application cluster as well. So depending on the workload requirements, you have several offerings available to choose from, between autonomous as well as automated databases. Since Oracle Database provides you choice of deployment, so if you look at the left-hand side, it is more of manual activity. So customers have databases installed on generic hardwares on-prem. And then even though those customers who have bought Exadata systems, databases are installed on Exadata systems, so that provides a lot of automation or health check, or don't have to build the entire things from scratch. So it has automated most of things. But if you look at the right hand side, we are moving towards most autonomous thing. So journey to the cloud can have different stages, and autonomous database cloud is also the same. So some customers are embracing cloud for new deployments or doing legacy lift and shift, but some other customers, they have huge mixed implementations where part of their systems are running on-prem and some are running on the cloud. So understanding where and how your customer might be using your data management solution, that helps you really scope out your autonomous opportunities. So as we see in the left side, we have most manual implementation. So more of traditional on-prem installs, either they are running on commodity hardware or Exadata. That is the land of the traditional IT DBAs. They are used to do maintenance, patching, upgrade, or you can say that most time-consuming stuff. So in the right side, we have moved through databases running on our cloud infrastructure. So lift and shift kind of opportunity is still a kind of heavy workload, and gradually we move through our existing database PaaS services, so Exadata Cloud or Cloud at Customer and Database Cloud Service. They start to introduce more automation as well as management capabilities, and that helps release DBA workloads into more kind of interesting tasks. So in the far right, we have end up with new autonomous database cloud services, and there you see all the benefits of reducing workload or risk or freeing up your DBAs. So those things are becoming true. So another advantage is like all database cloud service package includes database transparent data encryption. Enterprise manager packs, they include all of the EM packs such as data masking, subsetting or diagnostic, tuning, real application testing. They all come with enterprise edition version of the software. and high performance, which is available on this across this cloud. Like they are able to provide you multi-tenant partitioning, advanced compression, or database vault. So all these cool features. The extreme performance is adding on top of high performance, and they extend it by adding real application clusters or database in memory or active data guard kind of offerings. Autonomous database choice of cloud deployment. As you can see, we are talking about more of our platform services, where you have databases running on virtual machines of bare metal or Exadata cloud service or cloud at customer, autonomous, serverless, and dedicated. So there are several options, like in terms of management, DBaaS, VM, or bare metal is managed by customer. Exadata cloud service or cloud at customer is again customer controlled. Autonomous is controlled by Oracle, both serverless as well as dedicated. In terms of private network, you can have it on your bare metal or VMs, or even on Exadata cloud service or cloud at customer, you can deploy a database in private network. In serverless, you don't have that scope, and in dedicated, you can still control them, and databases will be in a private network. So in terms of single or multi-tenant, so it provides both single instance or multi-tenant, and in serverless, it provides just a single tenant, and in autonomous dedicated, you have both options available. In terms of software updates, it is customer initiated. In both of these automated deployments, and in autonomous, it is serverless has got automatic updates, and in dedicated, customers' policy controls are possible. In terms of private cloud, like this is not a private cloud, but it is not available in cloud at customer offerings, but Exadata deployments are available in cloud at customer behind their own firewall. And autonomous serverless is again not available, but dedicated is available on Exadata cloud at customer. So it offers availability, different database version support. So you can see DBaaS as well as Exadata related cloud service, they provide support for multiple database versions. Whereas serverless or autonomous dedicated, they only support 19c. And disaster recovery is possible across ADs and regions for both of these. So at moment for serverless, we don't have a DR as well as for dedicated. But that might be coming soon. So in case of hybrid DR, you can create a hybrid DR on these DBaaS, bare metal or VMs, as well as on Exa. But for autonomous serverless, you cannot do this, or even for dedicated, you cannot have a hybrid DR kind of solution. For consolidation use case, definitely these two offerings, DBaaS and Exadata cloud service or cloud at customer, is a good platform for consolidation. On dedicated, you can do that, but not on serverless. So when it comes to autonomous versus automated database service comparison, the use cases for autonomous database is mostly for where you need cloud elasticity, you need machine learning or kind of self-driving instant provisioning, always online kind of operation. There, it supports all sort of workload, like including JSONs, documents, graphs, and more. They are very good fit for autonomous database. For Oracle Database Cloud Service, as we've seen, VMs or bare metal or Exadata cloud service or Exadata cloud at customers. So it provides you great availability, flexible versions, and as well as features appropriate for small to large database deployments, whether single instance or rack or automated backups, patching, and customer controls. The difference between like customer control versus Oracle control, and that we have to keep in mind. Exadata and Oracle database is known, customers are using in their own data center and using it for consolidation and highest performance. So Exadata is not a very new technology. It is used across thousands of customers, and they are able to run their mission critical workload. Oracle database is used for either analytics or basically in do-it-yourself model within your data center. You can run it on any platform. So with this, I will move to part two of autonomous database dedicated. So we'll see that in our next video. And thanks for watching.